We have now finally arrived at the stage of placement. Our floor plan is ready. We have the block or chip dimensions, and pins or IOs are already set. We have locations for all of them. The macros, primarily the SRAMs, they're fixed. They're in place. We're not going to move them. They are located. We have power grid, and it's routed along and connected to the different things. And we have additional guides, which I didn't show over here, but things like fences, feed-throughs, pre-routes, different things like that, we can define them inside the floor plan. And so now we're ready to place our design. And how do we do that? We run with the GigaPlace tool, which is run. It runs concurrent placement and timing optimization. So that's with the place op design command. In the past, what we used to do is run placement. The placement was not timing aware or very not really timing aware. It would run placement, give a legal placement to our design, and then we would run op design minus post place, or minus pre CTS, I guess it was called, and that would do the timing optimization. Place op design goes and iterates between placement, optimization, and so forth. I guess the big difference is that just running running place design and then op design on its own, the op design won't do heavy changes in the placement, while place op design is built in to actually do this concurrent placement and optimization at the same time. Okay, placement runs early global route, which is also sometimes called trial route, and that's how it does its parasitic estimation and can figure out the timing, and it can figure out the congestion and so forth and so on. So you should also check congestion and see if you have expected hotspots at this time. If you do have hotspots, you know you're going to have problems with our detailed routing later on, so you better go and change things around in our floor plan. Maybe use some sort of partial blockages or fences or something like that to help it. Maybe you need to move pins, maybe you need to move macros, etc. So really you should check congestion at this point based on trial route. However, do not run DRC at this point, or at least not a full DRC, because trial route is not DRC clean and you will have thousands of errors all over your design. Finishing that, we can go over to the placement stage. So we're going to start stage placement. So at this point, I'm going to show you something that is not really nice that can happen and how we're going to overcome it. So if I look over here, I have my stripes, my metal two stripes that we have over here. And the thing is that if I put a standard cell, for example, a really wide inverter that has its A and its Y over here, can sit probably under the standard cells and use that area. But actually, it doesn't waste that much area, and I can really run into problems. These stripes are going to be long, and usually long nets and so forth like that will have special spacing violations and so forth. And we need to be really careful, especially because to connect to the pins inside the standard cell, we need to drop a via from a metal two somewhere. These can really cause problems. So what we're going to do is play a little trick. We're going to grab these nets. We're going to create a routing blockage on the net, where the routing blockage, which we don't really need because there already is a route over here, we're going to just have a double spacing feature on the routing blockage. So if we put a standard cell over here, the pin is going to be at least double spaced with it, and that will cause less problems for DRC. So how do we do that? I'm going to go over, and inside my SM floor plan defines, I wrote a little script called EnICS add M2 stripe blockage. And what it's going to do, it's going to deselect everything in the design. It's going to just use M1 name and M2 name to know what the string is for M1 and M2. And then it's going to select routes that are stripes that are on layer M2 with ground and VDD. So those are added to the select, like if I clicked on them with the mouse holding the control button. Okay, and then I'm going to go over each of these selected objects, which are the stripes. Okay, so they're going to become this variable stripe. And I'm going to make a routing blockage, where the routing blockage is going to have spacing that is double the minimum spacing of M2. And the area is going to be the rectangle of the stripe that we selected. So let's see what happens when I do that. So going back to my Innovus over here, right, I'm just going to run this procedure that we loaded before. And if you can see this, these stripes, they have kind of diagonals here, and these have kind of like a brick filling. So I'll look into it. They're a different fill. To see that better, what I can do actually is to go and I can't turn off the if I turn off the metal two layer, I won't see anything over there. But what I can do is over here we have blockage, right? And we have routing blockage, I can turn it off. You see there is a difference. So that is the routing blockage going on and off. And the other thing I can do is the routing, I can turn off the routing, and you'll see that the blockage stays in the picture. So I see that my blockage was created very well. Later on, I'm going to delete the blockage after we finish our placement. So now we are ready to place our design. We'll make some DB settings. So there are lots of DBs. If I do get DB minus category place, right, it's going to show us all the different things for place global, place detail, and what their options are, what they're set to. Most of them are defaults, but I may want to override some of them. So for example, set DB place global congestion effort auto, set DB the prefixes for instances that I will add during placements, or nets that I will make during placement, I will add those. And finally, I'm going to run the place opt design command. Okay, so let's do that. I'm going to set these three guys over here, and I'm going to run the place opt design command. Okay, the place opt design command is a long command. It's going to do both what used to be place design and opt design minus pre-CTS together. So it's going to have a timing aware placement where it's going to do global and detailed placement and timing optimization iteratively running back and forth. So that is going to take a little bit of time. On a bigger design, it could take many hours. What it's going to do, again, it's going to try to place all the standard cells according to the different approaches and algorithms that we saw in the lectures. So place opt design finished now. And now if we go back to our floor plan, we will see that we actually have our placement. So I'm turning off the routing for a moment. Okay. And we see that now all of our standard cells are placed, and they are not placed underneath our stripes. So the reason that they stayed away from the stripes is because we had that extra blockage over there. So we can see that we have our different standard cells and they're placed. And once we click on the standard cells, we see the flight lines, how they are connected to other instances in our design. We can also see the instance name down here. That can be useful for running a getDB or something like that. Of course, we can also go and anything we select is going to automatically open up inside the design browser. We can go through in the design browser and see the different parts that will go up to the top, and we have our standard cells. Again, everything is there. It's showing us what we have. And it also shows if we double click here on the output, it'll tell us what net it's connected to. The net is driven by this and it is driven to this. So there's a lot of things in the design browser that you can use. Okay, and now we have a place design. One thing I want to show you, so we have all these red lines over here. The red lines are obviously routes. If I load all the layers, we can see we have a lot of lines over here. This is the routing. Now, we didn't run routing, but we did run a trial route. So this is all a trial route. And in fact, if I run a check DRC now, I am actually going to have, it says here 643 violations. And you see that all over the place, there are violations. And the reason is because we didn't run a detailed route. We ran a quick, ugly trial route just to see if there's congestion and so forth. So that's why it looks like this. Don't pay attention to the DRCs that we have here after placement. As long as we're clean before placement in the floor plan, then we should not pay attention to this. In fact, if we do want to do something, we can delete the trial route. So we would write delete routes minus type regular, and that will delete our routes, as we can see back over here. But we still have all these violation markers, and looking in the violation browser, it's full of all these violations, which are not real. Again, in fact, we deleted all our routes, so we can go back and again run a check DRC, and it should come out clean, which it does not. Okay, so the reason it is not coming out clean is because we have the shorts, as you can see here, between the routing of metal 1 and metal 2 and the blockage we put on. Again, these are not real either. What we can probably do now is to go and erase our, we have a script to erase those blockages. So EnICS delete M2 stripe blockage. Okay, that is going to get all those blockages and erase them. As you can see now, there is no more blockage. If I get rid of the routes now, I'll unclick that, you see there's no more M2 blockages. And now if I run check DRC, it should come out clean. So now we see check DRC came out with zero violations because those violations were caused by the blockage that I had put over there. So this is the situation after we've run placement. So just one thing, we could have run placement from the menu. So there's a menu that says place standard cell, and it's a pretty simple menu, but there are all those DBs that you can set. So I just run it from the command line, of course, but we finished our placement and everything kind of looks okay, but to know it's okay, we go over and we run check place. So check place is going to tell us that it's checking the placement. There's a placement density of about 50%, okay? And it doesn't say that there are any errors, and that's a very good thing. It also tells us here that there are 77 placed cells and 0 unplaced cells, so that's good. That means everything is placed. And out of the 77 placed cells, 29 are fixed. So if we go into like this flip-flop over here and we hit Q, we can see different properties of it that we can also look at with the getDB. And one of the properties is called place status, and place status is placed because this is a place cell. That means that it's movable and all kinds of things. But if I go and I click on one of these like end caps, then what I will see is if I go down to place status, I see that it is fixed. So these fixed cells are the end caps and the well taps and so forth.
So we have finished placement and we have provided a location to all the standard cells. We ran global route for parasitic estimation and we applied timing optimization based on this global route. So to finalize the placement stage, we need to do a couple of things. The first one is to add tie cells. So in most modern standard cell libraries, we don't actually go and connect VDD and ground directly to the inputs of gates like this for constants. That's something that is not done for different reasons. What we do is we use a special cell, which is called a tie cell, which all it does, it provides a constant VDD or a constant ground voltage to gates. And what we're going to do is we're going to put one tie cell in an area where are lots of these constants and connect them over to them. But we also don't have an unlimited number of connections. We will usually put some sort of max fan out. So we use these DBs, set DB, add tie off cells. We give the tie 0 and tie 1 cells from the standard cell library. And then we say what the max fan out of each tie offs are and what the max distance from the tie off to the place where they're supposed to go. Then we run the add tie offs. And finally, we run place detail, which will go and do a kind of incremental placement or a placement legalization to make sure that things are set. Next thing we want to do is we want to buffer high fan out nets. So we're going to run clock tree synthesis in a minute, which is the most important high fan out net that we have. But there are other high fan out nets in our design, most notably the reset. So reset is going to be a high fan out net, which we didn't deal with up till now. And it's actually buffered during placement post-placement optimization. So we had this one driver that had a very high fan out, and we want to actually build a tree out of it. And so we do something like opt design minus pre-CTS with the setDB opt fix fan out load true on, and then it will go and it will run and buffer the reset tree and other high fan out nets. So this is something that is done post placement. Any changes in cell location require incremental placement legalization, and that is done with the place detail minus ECO true type of command. So that's placement legalization. For example, we went and used the place instance command and moved some sort of a standard cell from one place to another. And then we have to run this to make sure it is in a legal location and that it doesn't have overlaps and so forth and so on.
Having run our place op design, we want to do one more thing, which is to add tie cells. So tie cells, again, these are things that connect constants. And again, the command, as you see here, is just add tie offs, which is simple, but it depends on many of these getDBs. So if I do getDB category add tie offs, or just getDB add tie offs star, then I will see that it has several properties, such as which tie off cells to use and all kinds of other things, which prefix to use. And then I can run add tie offs. And it actually tells me that there were no tie-offs to place because my design is very simple and doesn't have any constants. But it will actually add the tie-offs and check
the distance from each tie cell to the cell that it connects to. A next thing that we're going to do is we're going to optimize timing. Now, actually, with the new like place op design type commands, it does the timing optimization, and we should check our timing reports and so forth after that. But if we want to run an incremental optimization, then we can do that. And in the forms, in the menus, it's under ECO optimized design. And we see that we have stages pre-CTS, that's post-placement, post-CTS, that's after building our clock tree, and post-route. And we can do all kinds of things. We set up and hold. Right now, we don't have hold because we're in pre-CTS. Incremental or not incremental, and or fixing design rule violations such as max cap, max tran, and max fan out. So there are a lot of these things, and there are a lot of options, actually. So for the options, let's go over here and do get db minus category opt star. And we'll see that there are lots of options. So post route and different things, opt hold. So there are a lot of options over here that we can set again. And so we can run a pre-CTS optimization. So that is going to be over here, opt design minus pre-CTS. And we're going to fix the design rule violations. So I'm just going to run that. And it's using the Giga opt tool to do these optimizations. And this, again, if it's a large design, can take quite a bit of time. On our small design, it will run pretty fast. And you see it already finished, and then we can create our stage reports. Okay, and then it's going to do our reports that are post-placement. We should do things like report timing at this stage, right? So going into our reports and into placement and see, we have our place, our timing reports. Over here, we have our reg to reg. We see all the timing paths. We see that we have a lot of positive slack here, so nothing to be worried about. And we can look at the different timing reports inside here.